It's your girl Ashley. Don't know if you can see me. I'm battling a really bad cold, so I'm going to flip the camera around and show you what I got for Christmas from my December book haul. And again, sorry if I sound sick. I'm battling a really bad cold or flu. All right, let's get to it. The first books I have to show you are from Book Outlet, the Black Friday sale. I did not get anything from the boxing sale, but I did get stuff from the Black Friday sale. We have Spellcaster by Claudia Gray. I read A Million Little Pieces, I think it is, or A Thousand Pieces of You, and I really did love it, so I wanted to get more Claudia Gray. This is about witches, I believe. Then I got Fateful by Claudia Gray. Sorry about the shining on the cover. It's very, very shiny. This is about a Titanic story, I guess. I kind of like Titanic. It really fascinated me. I got Plus One by Elizabeth Pham. Everybody and their mother has talked about this book. It's about people that are on a planet and they're the day and they're the night, and the cover is just beautiful, and I really look forward to reading this one. I got Broken Hearts, Fences, and Other Things to Men by Katie Finn, which is actually Morgan Matson. This cover is so beautiful and cute, and the cover, the back of it is actually pink. So adorable, and this is a contemporary read. Then Andrew gave me a $24 order to put through Book Outlet for Christmas, so I got the unidentified redhead by Alice Clayton. She writes the Wallbanger series, and I love that. I started reading it on my tablet, but that's that book. There's The Redhead Revealed. I'm not sure how these go in order. Then The Redhead Plays Her Hand. Then I heard Cassidy Von Shea talk about this, and I love her videos, and it's Helen Hunting Clipped Wings. It's a contemporary, I believe, about two people. Look at the back art, beautiful. The body art is hot, the chemistry is even hotter. It's like Good Girl, Bad Girl, I think. But I really look forward to reading that one. And then I have Inked Armor, which is the second book that I got, and that concludes my Book Outlet haul. Now I'm going to take you on to the books I got at Savers. The first book I got at Savers is Murder is Binding by Laurie Barnett. This is a mystery, and I'm loving his little mass-produced paperback mystery novels. And this is a Booktown mystery. The Truth About the Harry Kubert Affair by Joel Dicker. A very nice, big, flimsy, floppy book. It was, I believe, in French, and they transferred it to English. And it's in about an affair, murder, and a suspect. See, it says international bestseller. And then I got The Candy Cane Murderer. It's stories by Joan Fluke, Laura Levine, and Leslie Meir, I think. This is just some short stories about Christmas, and I should have read this on Christmas, but I didn't, but I picked this up. Then I picked up a trilogy there, well, not trilogy, whatever they call companions, of the Summer Boys novel. I got Summer Boy by Haley Abbott, and I heard good things about her last summer. Next Summer, and After Summer. So I got that series, and I look forward to reading it. Then I picked up Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. I really want to get the box set for my birthday, because it's coming up. My birthday is January 30th. But this was a little cute mass-produced paperback of Harry Potter, and I've never seen one like that, so I wanted to pick it up. It's the first book by J.K. Rowling. I picked up Philip McGregory, The Red Queen. I know this is on Stars, I believe. I just liked how it was small, and I like these books, and it sounds pretty good. It's about the Red Queen is the bad queen, and the White Queen is the good queen. And then I got Dean Koontz Velocity. This sounded so good, and what intrigued me was inside, if I can read it to you guys. It says, if you don't take this note to the police and get them involved, I will kill a lovely blonde school teacher somewhere in Napa County. If you do take this note to the police, I will instead kill a elderly woman active in charity work. You have 6 hours to decide. The choice is yours. So that sounded so good and phenomenal. Then I'm trying to get into classics, and I saw this one there, and I've never read it before. Lord of the Flies by William Golding. A very cute hardcover. It's the 50th edition, if you can see it. Really good. And there goes my dogs. Hi, Malty. Say hi. That's my doggy. And that's the book. Then I have The Wake novel, it's a Water Song novel, by Amanda Hawking. Very pretty. I think it's about mermaids. And now, on to Amazon. I got Wallbanger, I wanted to get this because I read a little bit of it on my tablet, and I wanted the physical copy, so I got Wallbanger. I got Sophie Jordan Firelight, and for me and you for Christmas, I got this book, Carol Goodman Blightwood, I think. It says, "Sometimes the truth is more sinister than the lies." And I think it's about witches and school, and it sounds really, really good. I picked up this random book at Dollar Tree. It's Sugar and Spite. It sounded really cute, and again, the cover is what sold me. Then from my mom, I got Karen Marie Moaning, Dark Fever, a Michaela Lane novel. I am like 48, no, 48 pages, 84 pages into it, and loving it. Really, really, really good book. I heard about this recommendation by Bookish and Nerdy. She talked about this series a little bit, and it really fascinated me. It's about fairies, and it's in Ireland, and it sounds really good. So my mom gave me a $25 card to Barnes & Noble, so I picked up this. I picked up Human Remains by Elizabeth Haynes. It says, "How well do you know your neighbors?" I got this book on sale for $3. Most of the books I'll show you was on clearance. They were 90% off, and I got free shipping, so it was an awesome deal. It's that book. The Departed by Shiloh Walker. I got this one for $1.99. It says, "Those we love never really leave us." And it sounded really good, and for $1.99, I couldn't pass it up. I got Easy by Tamara Weber, again a contemporary. It says, "Rescued by a stranger, haunted by a secret, sometimes love isn't easy." And this was, I think, $3. I got Foxy Roxy by Nancy Martine, another author of Sticky Fingers, and this is a Roxanne Abrazo mystery. I love the cover because I love animals and I love dogs. I thought this was so cute. And again, this was like $2. I got 666 Park Avenue. This is on ABC. This was $1.99. I loved the premise of this. It says, "What if your mother-in-law turned out to be evil, literally?" So it sounds really amazing. And then this was the last one for $3. It says, "I'll Never Get Out of the World" by Steve Early. This is about a guy in 1963, 10 years after he's rumored to have given Hank the morphine shot that killed him. He's haunted by him, and it sounded really good, and I loved the cover again. Such a beautiful cover. Then I picked up Suspicion by Alexander Morin, I think. I love the cover. It's so pretty. This is about, it says, "Take the Princess Diaries and add magic, murder, and mystery, and you've got Suspicion. A delightful read. Magnificent, mysterious, creepy. Welcome to Rockford." And it just sounded so good and so up my alley. And it just came out, I want to say November, so I picked it up. Really good. Now, these are what I got from Andrew. I got Bold Tricks, The Artist Trilogy. This is the last book by Karen Hale. I love her series. It goes Sins and Needles, On Every Street is in the Novella, and Shooting Star is the second book. I finished the second book in December. My last book I read in 2014, so I want to continue with the series. This is the very last book, and I'm very scared, not scared, but very sad to finish this trilogy up, but I will do a review on it. I got These Broken Stars by Amy Kaufman and Megan Spooner. Everybody talks about this series. This was one of everybody's 2014 favorite books, so I wanted to pick it up, and I'm a little about like 30 pages into it, and I'm really liking it. I'm just trying to take my time on it, but it's a really beautiful book if you can see it. And it says that it's a star-crossed like series, and they're not lovers, but they love each other, and it sounds really good. And then my last but not final book I got from Andrew was Wait for You by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I got the signed first edition, and it says Jen right there, and I picked it up at Barnes and Noble, and that's what it says. And this is supposed to be a very contemporary, good read, and everybody loves Jennifer L. Armentrout, and everybody raves about this series, so I wanted to pick it up and read it. And that concludes my book haul, guys. Sorry you couldn't really see me much, but the lighting is horrible, and I'm very, very sick. But I look forward to talking to you guys in January. I should have a small January book haul because it is my birthday. So we'll see what I get. And everybody, like I always say, keep climbing on. Bye, guys.